Hey guys, Sammy here, Blue Feather Homestead, and my little helper. Welcome back to our channel. Tonight I'm going to do a collaboration with Mountain Grandma. She did a video on Christmas gifting, and tonight I'm going to make some Christmas crack. And this is a snack, a Christmas treat that I give. I put it in little canisters with cookies and things like that. My kitchen is getting torn up from the floor up tonight, guys, like I'm sure a lot of other people's are this time of year. So anyway, if you haven't checked out Mountain Grandma's channel, you just must do it. She is like an herbal specialist. She makes a tea of the week. She also is a musician. Her and her husband are both musicians. As a matter of fact, I was rocking out earlier on their videos while I was cooking my cookies and things like that. So anyway, go check her out. I will put the link in the description. And it is Mountain Grandma. And they live in the beautiful state of Arizona. So anyway, you guys stay tuned and we'll get started. First thing we're doing is we're laying out some of these saltine crackers. My little helper is here. And she is laying them salt side down onto this baking dish, and this is parchment paper that I have lined on here. And if you can use aluminum foil if that's what you got, but you need to spray it, or you know, put some butter on it or something, put a little bit of grease on there before you put the crackers on the foil. Okay, so Miss Anna is melting 2 sticks of butter in this. It's about a medium to large size saucepan here. This is 2 sticks of salted butter. We're going to get that melted. Go ahead and put the sugar in. I'll hold this while you dump the sugar. Now she's putting a cup of packed brown sugar in. Come on out of there. There we go. Okay, hold on just a second. Let me break this up a little bit here. I'm going to get that mixed up. Okay, we're going to mix that up and bring this to a boil. So this is two sticks of salted butter and 1 cup of brown sugar. All right, it's boiling now, and she is stirring it. We're going to stir it constantly for approximately 2 to 3 minutes. And it's been going for about a minute or so. Let me kind of feel it here and see. This is making your toffee. And I'm thinking that that's really probably good. I have a pretty hot burner here. Yeah, I think that's good. I'm going to turn this off. Just pouring this over the crackers here. Will you get that spoon so we can spread it over the crackers, please? Pouring it directly over your saltines here. Oh, that looks so good already. Can you spread that out over the crackers? Okay, so that is spread evenly. I think that she did a fantastic job here. We're going to throw this whole pan into a 350 oven for about 5 minutes or until it's bubbly. So keep an eye on it. You see it bubbling? Yeah, pull it out of the oven now, and as you saw, it was bubbly, okay? It had been in there for a little over 5 minutes, so it needs to stay in there in 350 oven until it is bubbly. So now we're going to sprinkle our chocolate chips. These are semi-sweet chocolate chips. We're just going to sprinkle them all over the top here. I have about 2 cups in this bowl. You can use almond bark. You can use whatever kind of chocolate that you have. Let's go ahead and get these on here. But see, you can use almond bark. Might need some more than that. That's 2 cups. I need more. This is about a half a cup here, probably. Okay. Let's let those melt. And then we'll spread it out on top. Okay,
I don't know if you can see how they look shiny. When these get shiny, you can start spreading them out. That toffee should be hot enough that it'll melt your chocolate chips. If not, toss it back in your oven for a minute. I just want to say thank you, Mountain Grandma, for this collab. If you guys want to join in on the Christmas gifting collab, she will put this on her playlist. You just put hashtag Christmas gifting. As soon as I have this all spread out, we're going to put it in the refrigerator and let that cool and harden up. Before we put it in the refrigerator, we're going to put some sprinkles on here. This is the time that you're going to put whatever kind of sprinkles that you want to put on. We're just putting some Christmas sprinkles. Okay guys, this set in the fridge overnight and it set up very nicely. So what you do is you just start breaking it up, okay? You just pick it up and start breaking it up. You can do big pieces or smaller pieces, just however you would like. And the toffee didn't come out as hard as I like it, but that's okay. It came out a little bit softer. I should have boiled it just a little bit longer on the stovetop when I was making the toffee. This no big deal. It's going to still be just fantastic. I've already tasted it. It's delicious. You don't have to just wait until Christmas to make this stuff. You know, we have it all during the year. I make it, you know, February it's Valentine's Day crack, and March it's my birthday crack, you know, or St. Patrick's Day crack or whatever. Anyway, you guys, that's how you do it. You just break it up. And like I said, little pieces, big pieces, however you want to do it. Okay, so this is it, guys. This is what it will look like. Isn't that a pretty little gift? And this stuff is so good, I can't stop eating it. Anyway, thank you, Mountain Grandma, for this Christmas gifting collaboration. I had a lot of fun doing it. And you guys have a blessed and Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.